Hey guys, today I'm going to be showing you a few tools that I used. I got a message on one of the comment sections on this Wiseco piston ring compressor from Ricky. And Ricky's getting ready to build him a new 224 build. And he asked what other tools would I recommend besides the ring compressor. And this would be the main one right here. Would be the just a little 1995 dial caliper. And it reads in the thousandth scale. And also I've got a little, it's an eye gauging, it's a little bottom mount, and that helps you hold the dial caliper the steady when you do the piston height, deck height and stuff measurements. And it's really neat, you know. Of course, you know, I'm not going to have it zeroed up now. I'll have to set it back down on something completely flat to zero it again. But yeah, you set that down on your block and then you can run this caliper down in the hole and it'll read it out in thousandth, closest to the thousandth of an inch. And you know, you don't have to buy, they've got a lot better. You could buy like a Start brand or some of the other brands, and I'm not sponsored by any of these guys, but you know, those things are like, you know, a couple $100 or whatever. But now just this little 1995 cheapie from Harbor Freight, let's check it out. That's a 35,000ths feeler gauge. And wait a minute, let me check, make sure I'm zeroed first. Yeah. Okay, we're zeroed. Make sure there's no gunk on the caliper. All right, yep, that's zero. We're good. And what do we got? Well, looks pretty close to 35,000ths to me, you know. And usually, you know, these little calipers, they're pretty good. They'll get you within a thousandth of an inch anyway. But it's real important to have. You can check your sizes of your camshaft diameters. You can check the lift diameters on the cam. And if you're going to be working with these billet rods too, now these things has got like a 12-point rod bolt. And normally, you know, you'd want to get like a 12-point socket. Now this is a 5/16. That's not the size for the rod bolts on these. These are quarter-inch rod bolts. They won't fit. That's for a larger rod for a different engine build. But, you know, now this one, yeah, that's a quarter inch 12-point socket. And that's what you want. Now this happens to be a 3/8 socket, and I just got an adapter on there. But, you know, ideally, you know, a quarter inch or a 3/8 drive would work fine. But as long as it's a quarter inch socket with a 12-point socket, it'll fit those rod bolts. A 6-point won't. And I'd also recommend, you know, another tool here. It's and you don't have to have this stuff, but this is a little inch-pound torque wrench from Harbor Freight. And yeah, you know, I think, you know, they put them on sale sometimes $19.95, or I guess I've seen them for like $9.95 or something like that. But you know, they're cheap and they work pretty good. Just kind of breaking in a little bit before you start using it. Yeah, this one's Pittsburgh Pro. Okay. Yeah, you can spray a little WD-40 down in there or something, and they got a little grease on them, so you got to break them in a little bit. You know, once you break it in, you'll get the feel of it, feel where it clicks. But this little dial caliper is probably the most important tool here. That helps you get all your measurements correct, and so you'll know where you're at on your oil clearances and stuff. And get a little, you can also add a little scale. This one's a nice one. It says hello when you turn it on. So, you know, and they're about $20. But, you know, you can add that later if you want. It's not required. And none of this stuff is required, you know, to work on your engine. It's just, you know, what I would recommend. That's all I got for today, guys. Thanks for hanging out with me. We'll see you next time.